Good morning, children. Today we are going to start a new chapter, Let It Go. But before that, we are going to discuss something about the previous chapter, The Value of Time. So children, what you have learned from the chapter Value of Time, that we should utilize the time, is it whenever you get the time. We should never waste the time. Okay? So let's proceed to our new chapter, Let It Go. This is a story about two brothers, is it? And I think a new lesson you are going to get it in your life, for the whole life, that you should always forgive others and always give love to others. So here you see, he is Pranav and he is making a sand castle. Okay, so in this, here Pranav sat angrily on beach. He was upset with his cousin Rohit for irritating him the entire afternoon. So Pranav and Rohit were cousins, and one day Pranav was very angry with Rohit as because he was irritating him in the beach while he was making the sand castle. And even you too also feel irritated when someone disturb you while doing some work, is it? So in the same way, Pranav was also irritated by his activity, because Rohit broke the beautiful sand castle that he had built with his father's help. So this is a human nature, that you also get angry when someone teases you while doing something important work. Okay, then Pranav remembered walking happily with pail and shovel. Pail and shovel are the tools, is it, through which, with the help of this, you can make the sand castle. His father helped him a big sand castle with towers, walls and arch. He watched his father skillfully carved out the shape of the walls with flat knife. So he was just watching his father, that how skillfully, with the help of tools, he is making the sand castle. And the sand castle was completely as if it was appeared by the magic. Rohit came and spoiled the fun. And at the same time, Rohit came and what he did, he spoiled the fun. Then Rohit came. Okay. Pranav looked at his cousin, aunt and uncles enjoying the beach party. He saw his father teaching Rohit to swim and thought. So Pranav looked at his cousin and he was irritated. He was very angry and he was pretending as if he was his enemy. Is it? Because what he thought, that my hard work has been wasted because of his naughtiness. How dad forgive Rohit? He was so mean. I'll never talk to Rohit again. So he was thinking that why or how could my dad forget or forgive Rohit? He has done so so naughtiness. He broke his sand castle, and how my dad can forget or forgive him? Okay, so by this he was thinking, and he was just not enjoying in the beach, is it? So later, let's see what happened. You can see here how the both father and son are preparing the sand castle. Come on, Pranav, do join us. We are having so much fun, Rohit yelled. So Pranav's father asked him to join, but Rohit ignored and said, I'm sorry for breaking your sand castle. I was just teasing you. So he just said that I'm really sorry for what I have done, but this I was not doing for you to hurt, but only just for teasing. He was kidding. But Pranav was not ready to listen. He was too angry that he won't listen to him. He sat on the beach all alone, drawing on the sand and cursing Rohit. So here you can see it is written, I will not forgive. This was written by whom? By Pranav for Rohit. And he was cursing. Is it? And he don't wanted him to forgive. The waves came gently, touched his feet and rolled away. So as he was sitting nearby to sand, so simply waves came to his feet, rolled and just rolled away. So he was now feeling much better. His tempo was little bit low. The soothing sound of waves started to calm him down. But when he looked at the broken sandcastle, he became angry again. But again, when he saw his broken sandcastle, he was again angry. He wrote on the sand, I will not forgive. Even as a human nature, we do this. We know that this is wrong, but still we do this. His father joined him quietly, read what Pranav had written. He patted him on the back. Even your father too, na? Lovingly as a caring, said, son, you can always build a sand castle again. Rohit is feeling sorry about it. You should forgive him and let go of your disappointment. So his father tried to understand and he tried so that their bonding should not break. They should forgive each other and try to understand each other. But still he didn't want to understand. Is it? And again Rohit called out to Pranav, I'll help you build another sand castle. I'm really very sorry. So again, Rohit was very sorry for whatever he did. And again he said sorry for his mischief. Pranav felt much better now. He hoped Rohit would not notice what he had written on the sand. He looked down to see what the waves had washed away the words, I will not. So whatever words he had written on the sand, in that, I will not was washed away by the waves. And what was left? Only forgive. So this was really the magic, no? Then what happened? His father said, did you see how the waves washed away your forgiving, unforgiving attitude? When someone hurts you, forgive and let it go. So his father told him that, see, even the nature doesn't like your unforgiving attitude. And this way he gave you the lesson that we should forgive others. Pranav decided that he would accept Rohit's apology and become friends again. So in this way, Pranav and Rohit forgive each other and whatever mistake they did, they forget and now again they are friends. So from this chapter, what we have learned that we should forgive others from our heart. Is it? Even our parents, whatever mistake we do, but still your parents accept you when you say, I'm sorry. Is it? So we should be kind and we should forgive others from your heart. And that is the chapter's name, Let It Go. Clear, children?